Five types of biogas plants. The secret to selecting the best anaerobic digestion plant design. Choosing the right biogas plant design is crucial. Be sure to make the right choice. In the US, plant choices are based on what works best, not on subsidies. 1. Covered anaerobic lagoon. Popular on large US dairy farms, these use a flexible cover to trap methane. They are not heated, so biogas output in winter can be very low. 2. Plug flow digester. Ideal for scraped manure, these handle a wide range of solids. They can be more efficient for biogas production than complete mixed digesters, and many are heated for year-round biogas output. 3. Complete mix biogas plant. Also called CSTRs, continuous stirred tank reactors. These use mixing and heating for efficient digestion. This is by far the most common design used across the globe. 4. Batch digesters. Simple and best for residual municipal solid waste, MSW, or for the organic fraction of MSW, known as OFMSW. Batch digesters work best for stackable solids, not for liquids. Think of OFMSW as what is left over after the recyclable materials are first removed in those absolutely huge recycling sheds, known as regional recycling centers, seen throughout Europe. Number 5. Induced blanket reactors. Used for treating contaminated water such as industrial wastewater from factories, not slurries. These need a bigger tank than the alternative aerobic process and have a higher initial cost. They are quite rare, but are used increasingly for their improved sustainability when compared with aerobic treatment. In all these processes, anaerobic digestion is promoted to be used to turn waste into renewable energy and fertilizer. Of course, food crops could be used as feedstock. Indeed, whole crop from maize harvesting is often used, including the corn cobs. If ever anaerobic digestion processes were to consume significant quantities of food, enough to raise food prices, most people would object. But waste organic materials are so plentiful and so cheap that there has been no evidence that food production has been affected or will be affected in the future. The right plant design depends on your feedstock and goals. Every type helps reduce greenhouse gases. Choose wisely for a greener future. Thanks for listening.